Oh man, don't you hate it when, after, I don't know, a load of videos, you realise that you were working on something else and you took your watermark off? And oh man, I've got about 5 videos, maybe more, even, oh god, I've been thinking about a load of videos without me little one go watermark on, which is, alright, mildly annoying, but inconsistent and dashed unprofessional of me. I was doing something else in the editor that I was using and I just switched it off and forgot to switch it back on again. So you might notice that some of them are missing their watermarks. Doesn't really matter because, let's face it, I am now talking over these videos and it's kind of obvious that it's me playing, and that was all it was ready to prove, that it was me doing these videos. You still fancy your chances? Come to me now if you dare. Nah, I can't bother. I'm going to just hang out in my little lair here with my little beak. No, we're not ready. We're going to go and have a fight. This is Battletoads for the Sega Mega Drive. I remember playing this. I remember people loving this and I remember not particularly liking it because I frogging love brawlers, and this one is, as you can see, stringy and irritating. I've just lost a life without hitting anyone and I resent that, because it's just not balanced. I couldn't get a hit in edgeways then. Every time I move, I slide forward like that. It's like a single frame movement. Why do people love this game so much? I'm not saying I hate it. I just, you know what? I know it's like a joke and it's meant to be like a Ninja Turtles reference. We've seen it before. We watched Samurai Pizza Cats. Well, I didn't actually, but I hear it's a Ninja Turtles reference, and that's fine by me. But kids don't want to spend 40 quid on a joke. I can tell you that as a kid of this era who didn't want to spend 40 quid on a joke and never bought this game because, yeah, I get it. I get the joke. It's like Ninja Turtles are funny, or we're going to do a funny Ninja Turtles. That's fine, but the game's not that good. And I'm saying that having just started playing it. I have played it a few times and I never warmed to it. Not particularly. It doesn't have the pace that, say, the Ninja Turtles arcade had. The Ninja Turtles Mega Drive games had. And the Ninja Turtles brawlers are a little bit, what's the word? Lacking depth, I suppose. Even in the day, they were lacking depth. Bear in mind that they had Streets of Rage to live up to. And Streets of Rage was just full of depth. All it needed to give it depth was that grab move that they used really, really well. That's got to be food. Yay. They implemented it so well because it became absolutely essential to the gameplay that you grab baddies and fling them over your head into each other, and everything was interactable like that. There wasn't much breakable, I don't think. Well, maybe there was. Yeah, I think everyone was breakable, wasn't it? But there wasn't enough of it. But they still made enough of it in Streets of Rage to give the game massive depth. They kind of went a bit too far, Streets of Rage 3. Let's not even go there. It was still a good game, I thought. Not a great game, but a good one. Anyway, this isn't Streets of Rage, this is Battletoads. I don't remember it having a run move. I just accidentally double tapped and he ran. A little bit of depth. Ooh, I like it. Okay. But we fought the same baddie over and over. The same pink pig man with horns or whatever they are. I don't know. A little bit of Golden Axe that they run and attack you. But it doesn't have the precision that Golden Axe has. If the Golden Axe baddies run and attack you, they will knock you down unless you get out of the way. It's that simple. On the Mega Drive, at least. Some versions mess that up a bit, I think. Commodore 64, maybe. I'm looking at you. I can't remember. I did play that once briefly in god awful version. Anyway, I want a fly. Give me a fly. Have I got full health or something? No, I haven't. That's why I couldn't have a fly. But the lack of precision annoys me. I like this boss. This is cool. I like the little funny touches. That's not even a boss. This is what it's got going for it. It's got these levels. Can I have that? I can't throw it at you. Yeah, I can. Okay, it's got these levels that are a bit different. I'll give it that. Am I even? I am. Excellent. I like that. Can't knock it. It's a bit boring though. Once you kind of know what to do, you've just got to. I suppose it's like most bosses. He's just a bit slow and floaty. He seems to lack scale and detail. The sprite, I mean, the toad, whatever his name is. Have I killed that thing? Yes, okay. That was a nice touch. And I like the way his eyes bulge and stuff, it's all fun. It's just, she's like the Shredder lady. But Ghostbusters 2, which a level I never liked in Ghostbusters 2. Kicking Crows, eh? Where the perspective's a bit skewed by your drop shadow, your flow shadow. Not, I wanna hit you in the teeth, yes. I've got a feeling though, if I try and hit him in the teeth, I'm going to get bitten in the foot. I'm doing alright. It's not a bad game. It's got variety. I'll give it that. It's just... Everything's a bit small. And I don't like things like this movement up the ladder there. Up the rope there. I don't like stuff like that. It feels like I'm fighting against some kind of... Have I got a sword? Ooh, have that. I feel like I'm fighting against something. I feel like I'm... It's that FIFA... Not FIFA. What's the one? Australian rules rugby thing. Using the FIFA engine, but... With that feeling that you're walking through slime, that you've got a bungee. It feels like I'm attached to a bungee rope and I'm fighting against it. Does that make sense? That's how it felt. I was trying to express that playing that Australian rules rugby game. Or Australian rugby league. That's the one. Game. It felt like my player had a bungee rope behind him, you know, and they're dragging him back. And I hated that. Hated that. But this feels a bit like the same. The going left and right and up and down feels a bit the same. Funnily enough, I am currently attached to a bungee rope, but that's got nothing to do with it. The same sensation of just being dragged away from what you're trying to do is getting on my wick. It's not a bad game. Hitting in the face. What? What? Come on now. Right. It's not a bad game. It's got its charm. I love its big-fistedness. I love its bulging-eyedness. I don't really like the little robots. Having just played that... battle mech game with the awesome robots, and what's that lazy smash through the wall thing in the background where they've just done it on a square tile and hoped or expected it to blend in with the background, and it clearly hasn't. Stuff like that gets on me wick. That's just lazy. They've done transparency on the sprites. Do it on that thing as well. Maybe it is a tile. It's still lazy. They could have sorted that out. I want a fly. Let me have a fly. I don't know, I've never felt a sense of satisfaction playing this game. It always feels a little bit laboured, you know? I'm not happy about him. Or him. Oh no, it's dodgy. Oh, that was lucky. That was pure luck again. I've got myself a feather sword. Eat my feather sword over and over again. You miserable cur. I don't even know what a cur is. It's some sort of wolf. Care Bear. Sorry, it was just a bit too close to Care Bear. It tickled me. I don't know why that tickled me. It was like when I said Shredder Lady tickled me, and I'll tell you why. Because it sounded like I was saying Tenor Lady. And I don't know why that's funny. It just tickled me. I actually don't know why that's funny. It just tickled me. Oh no! I want me Care Bear sword. But a little fly will do. Check out the little green head on him. He's got two hits on him. Oh, he's biting me. Face off. Right, that's it. You've had it. You have had it. Sorry, I'm getting a bit irate. You know what it is? It's that battle with the blooming bungee rope. Oh, this level's too long. I don't like this level. I want to go back to brawling. Take me. I know I was dissing the brawling. I am sorry I dissed the brawling. Take me back to the brawling. I want to go back to the brawling. I like the brawling. Compared with this, I like the brawling. It's like they've gone, oh, you know what they really love? One of those Ghostbusters 2 levels where you go down the rope. No one liked that level in Ghostbusters 2. And it was like the best thing about the game. It wasn't a great game. It was like the only level people played, I think, because they got sick of it. I know certainly that was the case for me. Check me out. I've just proper owned those. Get off me. Get off. No. 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 I am acting a bit of a buffoon today. I don't know what is up with me. I got up really early this morning for no apparent reason, other than the little man was having a bit of a cry. Was having a bit of a cry. But not a cry, he was just talking to himself. So gave him a little cuddle on that. Held his hand for a bit, you know, and just chilled him out. And then it was like, oh, it's like 6 o'clock in the morning and I am awake. So I've just come down and played some games before I start somewhere. Good day. It was the greatest story ever told. That was Battletoads on the Sega Mega Drive. Thanks very much for watching.